Hi friends, this is Sonia here from Growing Craft, and today I have this beautiful Liquor Badge bottle tutorial to share with you all. So this was one of my empty jars from my kitchen, and I thought I should do some work in it, and this is how it has turned out. It looks fab, it looks beautiful, and I loved making this one. So this particular project is my thread decoupage tutorial. So here I am going to show you how to use your thicker threads and create nice textured background for your decoupage. So here to start with, I have cleaned my bottle really well with before starting this project, and once it has dried out completely, now I'm starting with my work. So I am using my liquid adhesive, and I am going to use my adhesive on patches because I really don't want it to dry out, because tying thread takes a lot of time and it is a very long process, but it is a really fun process because, and it also has so much of technique that it's not that you just took a thread and just start tying it. It has to be in a line, it has to have no gaps. Of course, you might have some at the end of the project, but then you need to try not to have the gaps, and also you need to make sure that the threads are really closer to each other. Now I'm using this bundle of thread which I got from a local hardware store. It's a 100% cotton thread roll, and which has a coating on it, a wax kind of coating on it, so it makes it easier to work with this. Otherwise, usually with the cotton threads, the strands may come out, but in this one there are no strands, and they are really 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 sturdy and very which has really good strength. So that's the reason I am using this thread. Now for the base, I have used liquid adhesive. I have done a project long time back. I don't have a tutorial of that, but I had used my tacky tape for that. So trust me, that was the no messy work at all, and it was really good. But I feel more comfortable with liquid adhesive because it gives you some time to push and pull your strings and remove all the gaps and all the spaces. So that's the reason I love using liquid adhesive. Now my thread is not a single piece long thread, so I am going to join the bits and pieces here and there. So that is something which you can really adjust when you are doing your sticking work. Now sticking the top part was a little trickier, so here I had to be really careful because the bottom portion of the bottle is just straight and the upper portion looks like a cone, so sticking your threads on the cone is a little tricky part, but it is fun, and that's the best part of doing your mixed media and decoupage products, that you can experiment and you just play around with the material. Now for the lid of the box, I have planned to use my thread only. So now I'm applying a very good amount of adhesive on my lid also, and I was sure that I'm not going to open this jar or bottle or use it in some other way. I just want to make it as a decorative piece. So here I'm going to tie my complete thread till the top of it. Thank you. once I'm done with the sticking work, I am just going to keep it to dry completely so that I can start with my decoupage work. And once it dries out, it's time to do the best part, the sticking off these beautiful napkins, which I have recently shared in one of my videos. Also, I had shared all the collections of my decoupage tissue which I'm having right now. So I'm also sharing the link of the supplier from where I get my tissues, and you can check with her. And here is this beautiful city print tissue which I've already cut the tissue, and now I'm going to stick it. Now for the sticking, this one I'm using my acrylic matte medium, and I'm going to apply a generous amount of medium so that it sticks well to my project. Now after drying out, I realized that there are so many gaps, but I've thought of a good thing, that how I am going to cover up all these gaps and make it something really interesting for my project, that you will see at the end of the video. Now sticking this decoupage tissue was really tricky, cause like I said, the bottle at the bottom is a circular one, and it has a nice round, but on the upper side it becomes a cone. So sticking your paper, your thread on the cone part is a little tricky. So here what I'm going to do is, here I am going to make sure that my design, the maximum design, looks beautiful here and looks clear. So I am going to make sure that the bottom portion has more tissue than the upper portion, because anyways we need to blend the colors on the top for some natural effect. I will be applying my matte medium in bits and pieces so that it does not dry out, as because anyways my threads are cotton, so it absorbs these things really quick. So that's the reason I am doing it in bits and pieces, and anyways that's the easier way for me to stick my decoupage napkins. Now on the top, yeah there are going to be some wrinkles, but I did not find any other way on how to stick it. But then once it dries out, you can't even see these wrinkles, because of the thread effect, your all the wrinkles and your overlapping of tissue just fades out. And with this, my decoupage sticking work is done, and I'm super happy with this, but I need to make sure that it sticks well. So here I have this plastic sheet, and with this I'm just going to give it a good press. This is just to make sure that there are no bubbles, there are less wrinkles, and even if there is a wrinkle, it presses really well and with smooth is it. Now my bottle has dried out completely and it's looking so amazing, and now I need to paint. So here I'm using my shimmer paint, and I am going to apply one good generous coat of paint on my bottle. Now the shimmer paints are one of my favorites. You can use them on your decoupage projects or mixed media projects, for your card making, like you just name it and you use it, and I absolutely love it. The reason why I chose shimmer paint is because it has some shimmery effect, and with the skies and all, the effect which I want to give, this is going to work really, really well. Secondly, it was actually matching really well. It was the exact shade what is there in the decoupage tissue for the sky. So I thought using this one is going to help me in having that monotony in blue color, and yes, it worked out really well for me. Now to fill up my gaps, I thought of using acrylic color, and I took a lighter shade in blue color, and I'm going to fill it with this lighter shade of acrylic paint. Now this is going to give a really natural effect of the shades, the variations what you see in the sky, and I was super happy that I thought of using this one. This actually covered all my mistakes, the thread which you can't see, the gaps which was there, and I really, really liked this one. So once I did it on my thread, then intentionally I did some on the bottom portion where the sky decoupage tissue is there, just to give a nice brush of work, and I'm smudging that with my finger, and this is just to give a natural effect of the sky, and it's looking just fab now. At last, it's time to do my varnish, and here again I'm using my water-based varnish, and I'm going to give at least two coats of varnish, because this bottle has thread, this bottle has decoupage tissue, so there are so many things that it comes in contact with water, so I need to be a little more careful. So here I'm going to apply two coats of varnish, and so with this my project is done, and it's looking fab, and I hope you'll enjoyed this tutorial. Before switching on to my next video, please make sure that you click the subscribe button, hit the like button, and do not forget to share this with your friends. Yes, I have few more videos coming up very soon, so please stay tuned, and thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye bye.